Yeah, I think.
Okay, hello everyone, and welcome to the top 8 of this League Standard or Gentry Standard event, where we have our one of the quarterfinals is Sander de Kank versus Stijn Bouhart. Let's have a quick look at what they're playing. I think it's Blue-Red Prowess versus Eldrazi Aggro. But let me just confirm that. Also, 21 players again, 21 viewers again, so welcome everybody. Let's make another announcement. Ah, no, it's Tutelage versus Blue-Red Eldrazi. Okay, so let's go. Make some announcements online. Okay, and our players are off with the opening hands. I think Sander already chose to keep. Okay, and we're off. Sorry guys, I was a bit silent for a second. I had some things I needed to attend to. Ja, 90 minuten. Okay, so both players are on their opening seven, and Stijn starts off with a gain land, and Sander as well. So you might suspect this is a mirror match, but nothing less is true. These are about as polar opposite to two decks as possible. The one is Blue-Red Tutelage, the other is on Eldrazi Aggro, I'm sorry. So you'll see Sander on the right will try to slow down the game to the point where he can mill out his opponent's entire deck, where Stijn on the left will deploy multiple Eldrazis, buff them, and attack for the kill as fast as possible. These players are in the quarterfinals, so they will, even if they lose, they win 7 boosters. Each time you win, you play for 50% more boosters, so the next round will be for 11 boosters, and so on and so on. Not sure what that is.
Have no fear, your head judge is here.
All right. Tell me what that is.
Ruination guide, lijkt me.
Ah, yeah, like ruination guide. So Stijn already developing his board. Sander playing a Magmatic Insight, digging for answers, I assume.
Love the Team Wrecking Ball token.
Yes, so Team Wrecking Ball is the token that's in the bottom of the screen. It's associated with our League of New and Beginning Magic Players, where we founded this format, Gentry Standard. It used to be called League Standard. And yeah, they're a group of more competitive players that have really took a liking to the format. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So in the meantime, we have some side events firing as well. I think that was a seismic rupture to clear the boards. Or a blazing salvo? I'm not sure. That's a roast. No, that's a... Not sure what the removal spell was that got rid of the last one, but that was a roast to get rid of the ruination guide. And now a treasure cruise to completely reload. You see Sander cherry picking which cards he leaves in his graveyard, because he is playing a Jace Vryn's Prodigy as one of his rares. Okay, Stain keeps pecking away. And I think that Sander already has quite a bit of removal ready. He's thumbing what I think is a seismic rupture now. He's also playing a Boiling Earth main, by the way. And he even has three Skyline Cascades. It's the land that taps down one creature. Well, it keeps it tapped. Another Magmatic Insight. Sander clearly digging for answers here. So far he's been quite capable of limiting the amount of permanence that Stain has on board. It's something you really need to do, because it can get out of hand so quickly and do a lot more damage than you might suspect from just a few tokens that are left behind on the board. We see that Sander does have a bunch of removal spells, though, some Fiery Impulses amongst others.
The Boiling Earth main deck is very good against Stan's deck.
Oh, but we have Chandra Flamecaller.
In Sander's hand?
In Stain's battlefield.
Oh yeah, I was looking at the wrong screen again. Yeah, that Chandra Flamecaller is going to do a lot of work. Yeah.
So that's 6 damage per turn.
Yeah. And a potential for a board wipe.
Yeah. And practically unanswerable for Sander, I think. So what do we have that answers this?
No. An Awakened
Fall of the Titans.
Fall of the Titans can hit it. Yeah. A Chandra Flamecaller of his own.
Yeah.
So assuming she's undefended.
Yeah, they both are playing the Chandra Flamecaller. Okay, so Sander at this point has 2 cards in his entire deck that
Boiling Earth for his Awakening cost.
Sure.
But those are long shots.
Yeah. He sends the tokens to sleep, I think.
Yeah. That was a sent to sleep.
And Stain just goes like, sure, I'll play my Drowned Sorrow.
Drowner of Hope.
A Drowner of Hope.
So Drowner of Hope bringing in the 2 Eldrazi's. Eldrazi Scion tokens. I don't think Sander can realistically threaten Stain anymore.
No, this is... Yeah.
Yeah, the tutelage is too little too late, I think.
Well, it's for the viewers. It's just to show what kind of deck he's playing.
There is a Seismic Rupture getting rid of the Scions.
Okay, so he cleared
and
that
yeah,
away.
Gets also rid of the Drowner of Hope as well.
But he's still on a 2-turn clock from just the Chandra plus 1 ability.
Well, technically, surviving to his upkeep is a possible win condition.
There are more lands.
Damn it.
What's making all this noise here?
Okay. The headphone from one of the computers down the line here. Yeah, so Stan is using our life total, little bits of scrap paper with life totals on them, for loyalty of his Chandra Flamecaller. And Sander, tormenting voice. Yeah, I think he's just gonna hope hope against hope to get the mill kill here.
Yeah, but that's a stretch.
Yeah, it's a long stretch, but
no, if he goes, I mean, magmatic.
And if he can cruise. If he can draw into another center sleep to buy himself another possible turn, Chandra Flamecaller is going to send two. Yeah, it's gonna bring it to one, but that's not gonna do anything.
And now he dies.
Yeah,
so
he's
one
just
turn
dead
too
now.
Late. Let's
yeah.
Well, let's see what happens first, but I think this is a 1-0 to Steyn.
Yeah, there are some
and
that scoops
they
him
scoop
up.
Him up. Okay, yeah. Let's take a look at what they have to sideboard.
So, Steyn has mainly instants in his sideboard. Like, he has two Disdainful Stroke, which are probably not gonna come in, since the only thing you can Disdainful Stroke in Sander's deck is the Treasure Cruises. You've got the spells, which are also not really good since all the draw is sorcery speed. Two Disperse. Disperse is probably gonna be coming in, since Disperse can get rid of the Tutelage for a turn, or potentially in response to a Treasure Cruise, which could prevent three triggers. The four Negates are very likely candidates to be sided in, since the only win conditions Sander is playing are his Tutelages. There's also a Superway and three Barrage of Boulders, but those are obviously not coming in, since the only thing they do is defy creatures. Steyn probably wants to get rid of the Fiery Impulses and the Outnumbers. Those are six main deck cards, and they only hit creatures. So, probably gonna get those out and bring in four Negates into Disperse, or that's what I do probably. Now, on Sander's side of the board, the sideboard is three Negates and four Dispel, none of which I think. The Dispels are probably coming in to combat Steyn's Negates, trying to protect his Tutelage. There's also a Reduce in Stature and two more Boiling Earth. The Boiling Earths are definitely coming in, since they're so incredibly good against all Steyn's Topters and Eldrazi Scion tokens. Furthermore, there's a Sarkhan's Rage, a Tears of Valakut, and a Demolish. Those are probably not coming in. And two Monastery Lore Master, although I have no idea what that card actually is. Yeah, I think you see Sander siding in some Negates as well as some Dispels. So, and Niels is back. So as we said, Niels, Sander is probably going to be siding in his Dispels.
Yeah.
To combat Steyn's Negates.
Yeah, that's anticipating what your opponent brings in is a large part of the sideboarding game, of course. But we don't have any super relevant things coming in, I assume.
Well, the four Negates from Steyn are super relevant, since they stop the Tutelage.
Yeah.
And then Sander's Negates and Dispels, which are going to protect the Tutelage.
So assuming that Tutelage isn't played. So assuming that Tutelage doesn't hit the board, he has Chandra Flamecaller, which can also be negated, and theoretically a Fall of the Titans for 20.
That's very theoretically. Or if, well, if he brings in the Monastery Lore Masters, maybe they can kill.
Yeah.
But
they hit for 4. So.
Yeah, if they're Megamorph, they hit for 4. So yeah, but I don't think those are going to be coming in.
I wonder what matchup he does bring them in for.
Well, it's probably mostly for the flip, recurring a non-land card.
Yeah.
So non-creature, non-land.
Maybe
so
this is his take on the mirror.
That's actually a good comment. It's probably going to be two in the mirror, where it's going to be a long game and you're going to need to get back lost.
Yeah.
Lost Tutelages.
We've seen people playing, what's it called, Cranial Archive?
Yeah.
On site.
Or Learn from the Past.
But that's an uncommon. Or?
Learn from the Past.
That brings one spell back, right?
No, Learn from the Past is the same as Cranial Archive. Except Cranial Archive is a 2-mana artifact with.
Sorcery.
No, it's a 4-mana instant. But it's 3 and a blue.
Ah, okay.
But it has the same effect of shuffling your library into your graveyard and drawing a card.
Yeah. Okay. In the meantime, we have 26 viewers, so we have a new record here.
Yay!
Welcome, everyone. So, please don't hesitate to put stuff in the chat if you have questions, remarks, if you think we're stupid or the most intelligent creatures you've ever heard to converse about magic.
Or both.
We already predicted one game from pretty much turn 2 to 9, so let's see if we can do it again. Okay.
Alright, so they're drawing their opening hands here, I think. Sten has kept, it looks like. And Sander is mulliganing to 6, I think.
Stop it!
The token, I assume you know, is a team wrecking ball token. It represents Sander, who's in that group. It's a group of competitive players that have taken Gentry Standard to heart and are our go-to guys if we want some more competitive input about the format.
Yeah, those are the kind of guys who are actually taking a day off and testing for our Gentry format for this final. So
in our top 8, how many of them are Wrecking Ball? I think 5 of them?
No, you have 2 members of Team Wrecking Ball. Tom van der Velde and Sander de Kank.
Yeah, Niels is sort of...
Niels is not really a member of Team Wrecking Ball, but he's the brother of and tests with him, so you can kind of lump him in there. And then you've also got Jelle Gessling, but he's not a member of Team Wrecking Ball.
Okay. So in the meantime, we're off in turn 2 already.
With the Hedron Crawler for Sten, I think he's very happy to see that.
Now that accelerates him into a turn 3 Whirler Rogue. He doesn't have double blue yet. I do see in his hand that he's holding another 2 Hedron Crawlers. I think he's less excited about that.
Yeah. Although, with enough Ruination Guides.
Yeah, I saw that in Luca's deck, it's a bit better. Because,
Chief of the Foundry.
I believe a total of 6. Lord effects, so
yes.
Things that buff everything.
Yep, correct. That's Luca has 6 of those. 4 Chief of the Foundry and then an additional 2 Ruination Guides. Turn 3 Tutelage, there you go.
Yeah, at least he played it. I think it was 2 days ago that somebody had a free Tutelage on turn 3 and chose not to play it. It was in round 2 because he wanted counter backup. When he could have played it with
for
an
free.
Untapped opponent. An out
a tapped opponent, yeah. So, Boiling Earth getting rid of both the Hedron Crawlers, and since Sten missed the Land Drop, that's gotta hurt. Or wait, did he miss the Land Drop? Yeah, he missed the Land Drop.
Yeah, he missed the Land Drop, but it was not a Hedron Crawler, it was a Sky Spawner with a token.
Ah, okay.
I thought Boiling Earth only did damage to non-flyers, but
no,
I'm wrong.
No, Boiling Earth deals 1 damage to all creatures for 2 mana with Awaken.
Okay.
It's the Barrage of Boulders that... No, Seismic Rupture.
Yeah, so... Sander looking extremely healthy and already sporting double Tutelage on 21 life with an opponent who is not coming out of the gates whatsoever. This is looking good. Now the Tutelage deck does have the problem sometimes where it stops drawing card draw spells and then giving his opponent a window into coming back. I think for Sander that's a little more relevant even than regularly. Because he's playing a little bit more removal, but he's still playing.
He's
the
still
full
playing the
package,
full 12, yeah.
Magmatic Insight, Voice, and Treasure Cruise.
And he's going to need them against Sten because Sten has basically no colored cards in his deck.
Yeah, that's true. He has no enhanced awarenesses, so that's the fourth. Oh
yeah, he doesn't
spell.
Play the enhanced awareness. Yeah, that's interesting.
It's the worst one of them. But
for the Tutelage deck, it's the worst one.
Yeah.
Yeah, and Stan concedes. This is This wasn't really going anywhere.
That's too bad. Let's hope that game three is a bit more entertaining.
Yeah, actually, it's actually a game. Alright, so I don't think these players are going to be sideboarding again.
Yeah, they don't. There's not seem really to be, yeah. anything that's I don't think play that draw dependent.
I don't think so, no.
No.
So.
No dying on the coverage team.
I'll try my very best not to do so. No, Stan trying to get away with a little bit of an edge for the next game. Or, no, he's fixing it already. Alright. So, we are still number 9? No, number 8.
Number 8?
Number 7. 8. 8. Oh, that's pretty good. Pretty good, pretty good. Alright, so these players look to be presenting for round 2. Yeah, they're presenting for game 2.
3.
Game 3, right?
We had a non-game, remember?
Yeah. It was such a non-game that I didn't even remember we had it at all.
Okay, right. So I see
lands.
Stain drawing a nice mix of lands into Pia and Kieran Nalar.
At the crawler. So yeah. Potential turn 3 Pia and Kieran could be. Yeah. I think that's
I
an easy keep.
I also saw a vile aggregate or a Kozilek Sentinel.
Ooh, that's
there.
Very interesting.
So it's pretty close to the dream hand for Stain, I think.
Yeah, it's pretty good. All right, Stain going up to 21 from the Swift of the Cliffs. Sander doing the same, and that's another crawler for Stain.
Yeah, double crawler again.
So probably going to go for crawler for 2. Oh no, he goes for the Kozilek Sentinel.
I think I would have gone for the crawler into Pia and Kieran.
Yeah, probably. That's what I would have done.
Unless he's holding a vile aggregate.
Yeah, or a counterspell. To protect against the turn 3 tutelage.
No, it's land, crawler, Pia.
I think.
With that hand, I would definitely have played
the Pia and Kieran.
Crawler. It's a hard word, apparently.
Crawler
into Pia and Kieran.
Yeah.
So in the meantime, what does Sander have in his hand?
Yeah, Sander isn't doing anything now, so he having the crawlers to play allows him to swing in for 2 this turn off the crawler. So Sander going down to 19. So what is Stan really planning here? Because all he has is a Pia and Kieran with 1 mana open next turn, or a crawler.
No, he's going for a Pia and Kieran next turn. He pretty much has to.
Yeah, if he draws a Vile Aggregate.
Vile Aggregate, even if you draw.
I think if you draw Vile Aggregate, you go Hedron Crawler, Vile Aggregate, swing in for 3 with the Sentinel. But there's a 2 touch on turn 3 again for Sander. Stan is going to need that Vile Aggregate now. But no, it's a Swiftwater Cliffs.
To be honest, I think that with a Pia and Kieran, if Sander.
It doesn't
light on the removal, but I think I saw a roast and a seismic rupture already.
I see a roast and a what's the fiery impulse? Fiery impulse.
Yeah,
so Pia and Kieran or no, it's a Whirler Oak. It's a Whirler Oak that came down, not Pia and Kieran. So Whirler Oak comes down. Stan swinging in for 2 damage? 1 damage? Yeah, 1 damage.
1 damage. It's whenever you play a colorless spell.
Right now he has to hope Sander doesn't have the second tutelage. I don't think he does. Is that the last card in his hand? Is that a tutelage?
I can't really tell.
Maybe so look again on the delayed monitor. It looks like a tutelage. Is that a tutelage or is sent to sleep?
I don't think it's a
tutelage.
Yeah,
it's not a tutelage. Who would have jammed it, I think. So, Rose takes care of the Whirler Oak. Fire Impulse takes care of the Hedron Crawler. And Stan in a pretty bad spot if Sander has the draw spells to finish it off. Since I don't think Stan had anything in his sideboard. Yeah, no, he had Disperses. So, he can... Wait, no, he had... Did he have the bounce spell that bounces non-land permanents? Disperse bounce is non permanent, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
So he has the disperses to get rid of the tutelage and then counter it when it comes down again. But that's going to have to happen real soon. Right, so Sander had been hit down to 15, but... Yeah, they won this spell and a land. Gone. Sander with a hand full of removal. And if he has the Boiling Earth or the... Yeah, no, just if he has the Boiling Earth, Stan is going to have a hard time recovering here. But no, he doesn't. He just passes the turn.
Seismic Rupture
is a sorcery, 3 mana, uncommon, deal 2 damage to each non-flyer.
It isn't even that good on this board.
Seismic Rupture, no, but Boiling Earth is good because it's a 2 mana sorcery that deals 1 damage to each creature.
Yeah.
So that works. Okay, so the video's frozen apparently. Come on.
This has happened a few times already. It recovers after a couple of seconds. So don't worry, don't run away. It will restart soon.
Yeah. Don't bother refreshing your browser. It's not you, it's us. Yeah, it looks to be pulling through.
Yeah, there we go again.
Yeah, so Stan played another Hedron Crawler and swung in again, sending Sander to 11. Sander is wondering whether he should play the Skylight Cascade, probably to keep the Sentinel tapped.
He has Boiling Earth.
He's gonna go for Magmatic Insight.
Yeah.
Drawing 2 cards, milling a Negate, a Ruination Guide, and some lands. So Stan losing counter spells really quickly. In his hat.
For Sander.
No, I don't think Sanders plays Barrage of Boulders.
No.
No. But it was a Seismic Rupture, I think.
Yeah.
Or was that a Fall of the Titans? No. That was a Fall of the Titans.
Yeah.
Used Fall of the Titans to get rid of the 2 Topters. And there's 2 more Topters from Pia and Kieran.
Yeah.
And swinging in for 1. Alright, so I think Stan is perfectly happy seeing his counter spells get milled, since the tutelage is there on the table anyway. So Negate and another Sentinel gone. A Fiery Impulse takes care of Pyrrha and Kieran. But
yeah, this is all pretty academic at this point.
Yeah.
Like, Sander has to top deck a relevant sweeper, meaning Boiling Earth at this point.
Yeah, but there is the... I think it's a Boulder Salvo.
Yeah.
Taking care of the Kozilek Sentinel.
Alright, so he's on a 4 turn clock at this point.
Yeah.
And I don't
Unless
think
Stan top decks a Ruination Guide, then it's a 2 turn clock. It's a Ghost Fireblade. That's.
Also a 2 turn clock.
Yeah, that's even better because that's not going anywhere. Sander is not going to get rid of that Ghost Fireblade.
Yeah.
And Sander's still stuck at the 3 lands,
yeah,
so.
I was just about to say that as well.
So no real way for him to get a lot of mill spells, well, a lot of draw spells off quickly. So Sander going down to 4.
I would have put the blade on the crawler though to spread out the damage more.
But I mean, Sander was stepped out,
sure,
and he has mana. He has mana plenty, so I don't think it really is gonna matter. So Sander just passes the turn. Probably has removal. Why is the Ghost Fireblade suddenly unattached? Yeah, Sander fixing it really. So,
sent to sleep
gives him
2 turns.
Yeah, 2 turns.
Yeah, yes.
But
7-fold spell.
Can you see that already? On the top 8?
Yeah.
Zeg maar, ze.
Ja, ik heb nu 2 verloren, zeg
ik. Alright, so we just got another result from our top 8. Jelle Gijsselink 1-2-0.
Dus
alright, now Sander roasting away the Kozilek Sentinel that just came down. And then Stan, now his topters do untap. No, they shouldn't untap. No, yeah, Sander just noticed it as well. They should not untap. And then the Ghost Fairmaid goes on the crawler. Crawler swings in for 2. Sander is at 2. So now he needs a sweeper and a removal spell. Fetching out a land real quick. Alright, so this draw is probably going to be the last draw Sander is doing in this tournament. Unless he sees some really good cards here. Alright, so he draws his card, Tutelage Trigger. Stan gets rid of a Sky Spawner. And Sander has a Whirler Rogue, a Dispel, but nothing that seems too relevant here. Yeah, a land would have been good for Chandra as well. That would have sweeped away. No, it's just another Send to Sleep, but there's the Negate, so Negate is going to get Dispelled. That's the end of the Counter Wars here, I think. Yep, so two creatures tap down. So these are creatures are now tapped and not untapping next turn. Ghostfire Blade goes on the top there. And Stan passes priority. So Sander now at 1. There's another Tormenting Voice. Sander still has 2 turns to get to a land and Chandra. Is that Chandra in his hand? Or is he just... Yeah, so he's keeping another creature tapped. So that works. And I think that's a Treasure Cruise. Yep. Or might as well be an Ancestral Recall at this point. No. Sander is still at 1.
So, hanging on by the skin of his teeth, I see.
Yeah.
So he has to deal with 2 attackers or kill Stain.
They're all not untapping this turn.
Ah, there's they're all Send to Sleep.
Yeah, two have been Send to Sleep and one has been Skyline Cascaded.
All right.
So none of them are untapping the next turn. So he has this turn plus the next turn to either find a board wipe like Chandra or kill Sten.
Yeah.
If he manages to come back, then that'd be certainly an impressive feat here. But there are cards for Stan that can... Wait, can Stan win the game from this position? Does Stan have anything that hastes? I don't think I saw anything with haste. No.
None of his burn.
No.
He has his Chandra Flamecaller.
Yeah, Chandra Flamecaller.
Yeah, that's the only thing that...
But Sander just played the Chandra Flamecaller and wiped Stan's board. But Stan's still... Well, those are tokens in the graveyard. That should not be happening. But Stan's own Chandra Flamecaller is still going to win the game. But it's not it. That looks like a Sky Spawner, I think. That's a Hedron Crawler. And a Sky Spawner. So that's...
Well, even the Hedron Crawler is lethal of the sword.
Exactly. So he can equip the Ghostfire Blade and hope that something survives next turn. Sander could minus 1 Chandra to kill the 2 one toughness creatures, but then he still needs a removal spell to deal with a Sky Spawner with the blade on it. But I think he has something in there. And also...
That looks like a very small library. All right.
Stan scoops him up. That's the game.
Wow. That's...
Or did Sander concede?
No.
Maybe this is something we should confirm before. So Niels is heading over to the players. What? Chandra was plussed, having him discard his hand and then draw 6 more, which means there were 6 triggers, which was lethal for Stan. Which milled Stan's library, meaning that as soon as he went to his draw step, he would have lost the game. So we have our second semi-finalist, that will be Sander de Kank. He will be playing... There we go. Sander will be playing the winner of the Jelle versus Nick match, but we already know that that was Jelle.
Nee, mag Wombeers
komen. Wombeers.
Ah, 2-0 voor mij.
Yeah, and also Niels van der Velde winning his match 2-0. Jelle G is playing. Jelle Gesling, what speelde hij?
Prowess.
Yeah, Jelle Gesling is on UR Prowess indeed. And the other top 8 players are Luca van Deun, Niels van der Velde, Casper Browns, Tom van der Velde, Nick van den Broek. And then the feature match here, Stijn, Bogaert and Sander Kank. Of course, Sander won his game 2-0, 2-1. Jelle won his game 2-0 and Niels van der Velde also won 2-0.
So at this point, Stijn is also contemplating the fact that he might have missed one damage somewhere and could have, should have won game 3.
That is something to check back in the VOD afterwards, and if it is true that he actually missed a damage somewhere, then that could be very, very painful. Alright, now we have one more match happening here. This is Casper versus Tom van der Velde, but since we don't have those on camera, we're just going to give you some filler until that match actually gets done. So I will see you then when we start the semifinals, which should normally be held consecutively, not simultaneously, so you can see all the semifinals. Thank you guys for watching so far, and I'll see you for the semis.
Slipping into the planeswalker at this point. So if he can trigger prowess and Friedrich has no response, this is for lethal. So Friedrich doesn't want to give him a chance to do so. It's quite likely that Edouard is holding counter magic at this point. So trying to kill something awkwardly could mean you get killed instead. I'm pretty sure this is game now. You see a Pearl Lake Ancient in Frederick's hand, but I'm afraid that won't be enough to do anything here. Edouard just checking to make sure that he knows what his cards are doing. So, and he's getting ready to flip it. So if you know you're going to flip it at that point, it is a good practice to possibly just discard the card you want to flash back in order to maximize your card advantage. I think it's a bit over the top at this point, since I don't really see a way for Friedrich to dig himself out of this.
I was playing really safely. Okay, so he needs counters. So he decides to put the spell back into his hand. Is it into his hand?
No, you get to cast it from the graveyard that turn.
Okay.
So, yeah. So does Edouard have this Disdainful Stroke? Frederick was a... Yeah, expedite.
Yeah,
the kill goes around it. And we're on to game 3. So apparently Edouard was holding a bunch of counter spells and irrelevant things while Frederick wasn't drawing any removal. So the game ended up a little bit awkward, but that happens from time to time.
Yeah, also it's a bit difficult when you're playing against the control deck because you don't know what they have in hand, so you really want to keep your counter spells in hand, not throwing them away.
Edouard did have
the last
opening,
turn
except awesome. If you had the third land on turn
yeah.
3,
that's really nice.
It would have been, I guess, the nuts for this deck, right?
Yes, yes, definitely. Also with a bit bad luck from Friedrich's side, with the Mulligan 2-5, and then...
So at least this time Friedrich is on the play. I sort of hope he got very unlucky in game two, because I didn't really see any impactful sideboard cards appear in the game. So it could be that he's underprepared for this matchup as well.
So how many players showed up today at the Evening League Standard?
Oh, we had 29 players, which is a good number. It's the numbers we've been sporting at the last couple events as well. 24, 32, 29 was the last couple. It's a really healthy community at this point. And we have a few people who are really motivated in pushing the community forward. Me, for one, from a purely community point of view. But we have Tom van der Velde, who's a very good deck builder, who has decided that League Standard is an awesome format, and he wants to dedicate quite a bit of his free time to it, helping people out with their decks. We have Sander de Kriek, who sort of replaced my duties here locally, so I can devote more time to this digital content and to trying to start up little League Standard hubs elsewhere in Belgium. So there's a lot of interesting stuff happening right now, and this stream is the proof that we're still going forward, still keeping up with trying to spread the word about this, because I just think it fills a niche that Magic needs at this point.
Yeah, because it's in my opinion, it really feels like a mixture between casual and competitive, especially with these kind of tournaments. They are really, really casual. They feel really casual, but at the same time, you can win a few boosters, which makes it fun as well. The community here is really great. Noticed it quite a while. And I also saw about Tom van der Velde making a lot of pages on the website from League Standard about what decks to beat, and giving very good overall tips. Also talking about a lot of played cards in the format, which makes it really easy if you want to step in to this, so you know what you can expect. Makes it a really, really nice format.
So if you're interested in any of these articles, you can find them all at leaguestandard.wordpress.com. We are currently working on a new website, cleaning up the layout a little bit, making sure the content is more visible. But right now we're still on League Standard, even though the format is changing its name to Gentry. Okay, in the meantime, we're into game three. We saw a mulligan from Edouard, but again, he has his dream opening of Monastery Swift Spear. Let's hope that Frederick has a little more ability to interact in this game than in the previous one. And we're back to game one. Let's see if the Flaying Tendrils punishes him as badly as it did last time. Grasp of Darkness from Friedrich is a pretty big sign that he doesn't have the tendrils in his hand at this point. And Friedrich apparently stuck both on two lands and only black mana, so that sign there. This could easily be the end of Friedrich already at this point. Elusive Spellfist. That's the Trinity. The Monastery Swift Spear, Elusive Spellfist, and the Storm Chaser Mage. Yeah, Oath of the Gatewatch with the Storm Chaser Mage really finished up this deck.
Yeah, it really did. I didn't play that card because I was playing White. As well, and Sigurd away was a bit better than the cards.
Okay, so let's see. That is Titan Strength, so this is an attack for 6 at this point. And then Expedite makes it for 7, and the Spell Fist triggers, and so it's for 9.
This is going fast.
Okay, Friedrich draws his third land, so he has the tendrils available now.
He should be playing, but there's a blue mana open from Edward, yeah. Which could mean
he... Yeah, it could be the dispel, yeah. And also it only kills the Swift.
Okay, viewers, hello and welcome. Are you ready for the semi-finals? We'll try to give you both of the semi-finals. Unless the players would rather play earlier, in that case we will let them play on. So I'm gonna debrief the players and then we'll get started. All right. So, let's get the deck list. So, Sander managed to win against Eldrazi aggro, but now he's against the other blue-red aggro deck, the Prowess deck. So the Prowess deck has quite a different way of playing. It's very capable of doing a very strong initial burst, but also capable of reloading through card draw and then coming for a almost combo finish with haste creatures that get double strike and pumped. Okay, both players are looking at their opening sevens, I think. Or one, two, three, four. Yeah, both are on sevens and ready to go. Yeah.
We do this.
Okay, so Sander joined us again.
Hello.
That's Sander the Quick, not Sander the Kong, obviously.
Yeah, we are actually from way too close geographically. We're from the same.
You and Sander.
Yeah.
Okay.
The same city. Well, no, the same area.
Okay. So in the meantime, Yala got on the board with Storm Chaser Mage.
As your prowesses want to do.
Yes.
And that's the baby Jace. So this is probably gonna get killed real quickly.
Yes. Yala is playing some removal. I know some blue-red prowess decks aren't playing, but I'm not sure if
Yala
he
is playing.
He has the impulses on the side.
He has impulses on the side, but he is not playing any removal main board. He used to play a Spark Mage's Gambit, but it's crossed out, so he's playing no removal, so he's not going to be able to deal with the Jace as easily as I thought.
So this is a deck that goes pretty much all in, especially game one. The entire plan of the deck is to either beat you down in the first 4 or 5 turns,
yeah,
or beat you to 10 in 3 turns and then reload and hit you for another 12 out of nowhere somewhere around,
yeah,
turn 8.
Yeah, exactly. I feel it.
That's Yori N. So Yella can at this point choose to go a more grindy route by playing two spells.
Spells during getting extra draws, especially with Expedite and Slip Through Space, that will get very, very strong very quickly,
yeah,
because they draw a card on their own as well.
Yeah, we already saw that he is holding a second Storm Chaser Mage. So that's a great
spell. And also
spell.
Titan Strength, so
yeah,
even if he doesn't have a fourth land, his turn four of Storm Chaser Mage, Titan Strength, one of them, plus draw a card from Jorian can be very powerful. So Sander got the Jorgian out of the way. And also can now activate Jace to flip it.
Yeah.
Also not unimportant.
Yeah, there's only one creature it actually blocks, so it's the...
Yeah, I don't think you want Jace as a looter here.
Swift spear.
I think you really want Jace, just keep plusing him. Since it's up,
well,
since
just
a plus two.
Flashbacking the Fiery Impulse is pretty good at this point.
Well, yeah, assuming he doesn't have another removal spell in hand. Because if he manages to ultimate the flip Jace, he's not losing the game. And it only requires two pluses, so...
Yeah, but with all the haste creatures in Yala's deck, that's such an iffy plan.
Yeah, fair enough. But it does give him more time where his life total isn't pressured and where he can just work towards his tutelages. Well, I would probably go for a plus to ultimate route.
I think I go for a minus and make sure I get a creature off the board.
Yeah, well, he has the Fiery Impulse in hand and he can keep the Storm Chaser Mage tapped, so... He could just technically keep him on the off the board.
So he hasn't used it at this point.
Not yet, no. Probably still contemplating what to do with it. Yeah, it just goes for the tutelage and pluses the Jace.
Okay, so you were right. Yeah, it goes to 6.
Yeah, it's actually to 9, not to 7. I was wrong. Or is it 8?
I have no idea. Let's look it up.
Yeah.
It's minus 9. Okay, apparently we have a judge call here. I think Yellow was attacking the Jace.
Alright, this is a very, very problematic moment here. Sander discovered he still had one of his sideboard cards in his deck. And this is a decklist problem. Which leads to a game loss. And no, there is no downgrade. The downgrade is only if you discovered before taking any game actions. So this is a very, very much of a feel bad moment, but Sander losing game one to a decklist problem. And also our camera losing two, stuttering.
Tom is nog aan het spelen. Ja, dan is nieuwste. Okay, so we're back. Sideboarding is underway. Let's take a quick look at the sideboards and see what the players have. First, Sander, because we already had him last time around. He has three negates and four dispels, which can all be used to counter. Yeah.
Dragons of
Tarkir well, battle for Zendikar.
Okay.
Yeah,
Almo? So, Anne Exile. This Ode of Dragons.
Merci. Asseblief. Alright, sorry, we just had to pay out some prices for the quarter finalists. Back to sideboards. For Sander, we have three negates and four dispels in a sideboard as relevant cards. A reduce in stature. Ah, sorry. So we have three negates and four dispels coming out of the site. One reduce in stature that's going to be relevant as well. And I guess the one of Sarkhan's Rage can also help. For Yelle, we have two dispels and two negates. Maybe the Disdainful Stroke if he's worried about Sander's Chandra. But that's pretty much all there's coming in. So a lot of counter spells that are going to change that tempo of the game. So look forward to a much more controlled second game. Okay, and again our camera is stuttering a little bit, but we're in between games, so it's not that much of a problem. 20 viewers at this point, welcome everyone. Yelle is playing blue-red prowess, and at this point we have in the top 8 Niels van de Velde and Tom van de Velde, who are queued up for the second semi-finals, and here we have Yelle versus Sander. Now apparently we lost connection, let's try and fix that. Okay. We have a remote desktop that tries to fix this. All right. Not active.
Zit jij nog verbonden met het Outpost netwerk?
Ik ben plugged in, dus ja.
Ah, wacht. Die wil is niet actief.
Okay, sorry for this, people. We're trying to fix. Alright, let's. Still nothing! Not active! Okay, we're gonna switch back to some earlier documentation in the meantime while we try to fix this.
3 toughness. And he chooses not to do anything. So he wants to do it in the upkeep. That seems like a bad decision for me right now. Eduardo has more mana available, and he still gets the